A strange habit that I appear to have is, on a lot of Fridays, I watch Jeopardy while running on the treadmill. And I had to run a little bit more after Jeopardy was over tonight, so I decided to stick around and watch Wheel of Fortune. Great. Make myself feel smart. As I was watching, the girl two treadmills over hadn't started running yet, and she managed to fall off an unmoving treadmill. It's going to be very difficult to top that. All right, so another week contest to end our week. We've got Chip, our champ, in second place. Still kind of cracks me up with 6,000. Joe, our challenger, in first with 11,600. Not a runaway, as Alex will remind us. And Dana in third with 4,600. We'll start with first and second, Chip and Joe. Chip doubles up. He's going to have 12,000. So Joe will want to wager 400 at the very least. If he gets it wrong with that wager, he's going to be left with 11,200, so Chip's going to need to wager at least 5,200. Now for Dana, she's out of contention because she has less than the difference between Chip and Joe. Chip needs to wager at least 5,200, so he'll have 800 if he is incorrect at most. So Dana will want to wager up to 3,800. Again, she can't win, so she might as well play for second. And since Joe has such a commanding lead, he could wager more than 400 if he wants. He can wager up to 5,600 against Chip, but Dana will get 9,200 if she's right. The difference there is 2,400, so he can wager up to 2,400. Now, I like all three of these wagers. Dana's not so much, but Chip made the rational all-in wager, trying to maximize his winnings. Unfortunately, Joe didn't get it right, so he was very close to winning, and it just slipped through his grasp. I gotta say, I feel really bad for Joe. From personal experience, I know that it's very tough to go into final with a huge lead, but not quite a lock, and then lose it on the final question. But it's part of the game, and we'll see what Chip does on Monday. And I hope to see you then too. Thanks for watching The Final Wager.